Today, we will learn how to make dice rolling. Let's start. In the scene, we have canvas contain text, a plane with four wall colliders to prevent the dice from falling, the dice, and we add rigid body and box collider to it. Now let's set up the dice. Create empty game object, add sphere collider and make it trigger. Resize it to fit the dice face and duplicate it 5 times. Now we have 6 game object with trigger sphere collider, and because we want to return the number of the face that is opposite to the face that we are colliding with the ground, we have to rename the empty game object with the sphere collider to the face that is opposite to it. For example, if the dice land on the face number 6, that means that number 1 is colliding with the ground. And if the dice land on number 3, then number 4 is colliding with the ground. In dice roll script, we need a rigid body, 2 private float, max random force value, start rolling force. We made them serialized field, so we can change them in the inspector. 3 private float, force x, y, and z. And finally, we need a public int dice face number so we can access it later on from the other script. In wake, we just call initialize function that get the rigid body component and set it to kinematic. Also, it randomizes this game object rotation on x, y, and z. In update, we check if the user click on the left mouse button, so we call the roll dice function. Roll dice function is responsible for rolling the dice randomly on all the axes. First, we get the rigid body and set isKinematic to false so it can interact with physics. Then, we assign a random float range from 0 to max random force value to force x, y, and z. Then we apply force on the up direction multiplied by start rolling force. Finally, to make the dice roll, we add torque using force x, y, and z on all the axes. With that, dice roll script is ready to use. In face detector, we need an instance of dice roll script and assign it in awake function. We use onTriggerStay function because we will read the dice number only when it's completely stopped. Inside onTriggerStay function, we will check if the dice is not null and if the rigid body velocity is equal to 0. And here's why we need to name the faces with only numbers, so we can convert it from string to integer and assign it to the dice roll script.diceFaceNumber. Score script is responsible on showing the dice result on the screen. We need instance of the dice roll script and the text. In wake, we will get the instance of dice roll script, and in update, we will check if the dice is not null and if the dice.diceFaceNumber is different to 0. Then we will change the text to the dice.diceFaceNumber. Finally, let's add the scripts to the game objects. Dice roll on the dice and change the values as you wish. Face detector on the plane and score on the canvas, and we have to assign the text on the text field. With that done, let's try and see the result. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video. See you in the next video. Peace.